algorithm. Okay, here we are the last algorithm that I would like to tell you about, the efficient sorting algorithm. This is the quick sort. As its name, right, it's quick, very quick sort. Right? Quick sort is widely used sorting algorithm developed by Hoa, right? Car Hoa, that will make the also n log n, log n based to comparison as well. Similar to the merge sort, right? And in average case to sort an array of n element, right? However, in the worst case, it has a quadratic running time given as n raised to the power 2. What is the worst case for the quick sort algorithm? The worst case out of quick sort algorithm will be the if the list of data has been sorted, or the sorted data is used for sorted. So the quadratic time comparison computation will be applied, and it is the worst case for the quick sort. So, okay, basically quick sort algorithm is faster than others with n log n algorithms because of its efficient implementation and can minimize the probability of requiring quadratic time. Quick sort, sometimes we have done it as the partition exchange sort. Like merge sort, this algorithm works by using divide and conquer strategy. Divide and conquer strategy will be used for both merge sort and quick sort. And this strategy will make these two algorithms to have the big O n log n complexity. Okay. So let's just show you about the quick sort algorithms. Okay, suppose we have a list like this, right? And an array of number, right? First of all, you have to select the pivot. P stand for, or is an abbreviation of the pivot, P-I-O-V-O-T, pivot. Sometimes we can select pivot from the first element of the array. Or sometimes you select the last element, or sometimes you can select the mid element, but for the whole R or the quick sort, right, we'll use the P, the pivot will be the first element, and then try to partition into two parts. The first part of the numbers will be less than P, and the last part of the list will be greater than the number, the P. And then once you can find the element, and then you will swap P to here. Okay, select pivot element P first, and rearrange the list into two subarray L and R. L to the right hand side, to the left hand side, and the right hand side. L has S element less than or equal to P. Otherwise, R has remaining elements greater than equal to P. And then we exchange the pivot element with the last element of L. Suppose this one, we have the list of element like this. So we swap P with the element here that is less than P, right? So you will partition into two parts. This part will be less than P, and this part will be less than, greater than P. Okay. And then we will sort L and R recursively. Okay, do you understand? Maybe I will show you the next figure. Suppose we have the original list in display one, and then first you have to select the pivot that is the first element of this array. And then you have to move the element, you have to check P with the element, right, each element. If each of these element is less than P, it will be in the green one. And the element that is greater than P will be the pink one. And then once you find the last, you can partition like this, right? And then you have to move P to this position. Why? because we have known in advance that the green one will be less than p and the pink one will be greater than p, right? So the correct position of p will be here. So that's why before we will go to the next step by sort, by perform quick sort the green one and perform quick sort the pink one. So you have to move p to the correct position. That is a middle or in this way, in this index. Okay. Do you understand? Okay, so let me give you an example. Suppose we have a list of numbers like this, right? First, we select 5 as a pivot, and then you have to scan to the right, right? Scan to the right. 3, if 3 is less than 5, do nothing. If 1 is less than 5, do nothing. If 5 is less than 9, now, you have to stop here and then go from the back. It's 7. You compare 7 with the 5, right? So 7 is here. So now we compare 4 with 5. 4 is less than 5. So what shall we do? Stop. Now we will stop. And then what shall we do? I will swap 4 and 9. So 4 will be here and 9 will be here. So we can continue standing, scan to the right. Okay, then we have 8 here. 8 is greater than 5, so stop. And then 2 is less than 5, stop again. And then swap 8 and 2. So we'll be green and pink, green and pink. Now, I is 5, and then J is 4. If 5 is greater than 4, then we will stop. So this is the ending condition for this loop. Okay, so if I is greater than J, so it means that it has already crossed each other. And then we have to stop. Now we have the green one and the pink one, right? The green one, the green list will be less than 5, and the pink list will be less than greater than 5. So what shall we do? You have to swap. Okay, now J is 4, right? You have to swap the elements in J and the pivot. Swap 5 and 2. So now 5 will be in the correct position, right? And then we set to gray, right? So this is more or less we say it's a middle, right? Middle. And then what shall we do? We have to sort the green one and quick sort the pink one. So this is a way of the quick sort algorithm does. Okay, very simple, right? We can use HOAR algorithm, C-A-R, HOAR, right? So actually, when we talk about the quick sort, right, it was developed by HOAR. And this partitioning algorithm was also developed by HOAR as well, C-A-R, HOAR. Okay, and this one will be called quick sort. So this is the conclusion of the quick sort, right? First of all, you have to select a pivot and scan to the right until AI is greater than P, and then scan to the left until encountering AJ is less than or equal to P. And then if I is still less than J, then we swap the element. Okay, swap an element and continue scanning. Okay, this is the common situation, and then you continue scanning. And the second case, right, if I is greater than J and J is less than I, so now we can partition until the, okay, this is a critical situation, right? J is here, I is here, we cross, the index has been crossed each other. So what shall we do? We have to swap the current position of J, index J, right, with the pivot position, right, index 0, and then P will be at this position where S is equal to J. And the last one, if you found out that I and J is equal, is possible, right, So you can have this one. So what shall we do? We have to copy. Oh, once we hand it, so it might be the same number as P. So you don't have to do anything. You don't have to swap. Only the case that I is equal to J, it means that P or the value in this position is exactly the same as the pivot position. Okay? Okay, here is the Hoare partitioning. Hoare partitioning function, right? Hoare partitioning function is to select the pivot. That is the element A, L, right? The leftmost element, and then try to partition, right, into green and pink, right, or less than or equal to P, or greater than or equal to P, right, and then you can do. This is a very simple algorithm for the Hoare position. And then you can keep doing this, and then you can come up with the sorted list. Okay, and this one is a quick sort. Right? Quick sort, do we have to partition? Okay, you can use partitioning, right? And partition A, L, and R, right? And S will be the pivot index. And then you perform quick sort L to S minus 1 and quick sort A, S plus 1 until R. Why? Why is that? It is S minus 1 and S plus 1. Why don't we have L to S and S plus 1 to R like merge sort? Why? Why? Anyone in this room can answer my question? Jinta Reed 3402. Why? Why this index is not S? Jinta Reed ka? Why is that? Jintarit, are you sleeping? Anyone in this room can answer my question? The answer is because the pivot is at the correct position already. P, the pivot is at the correct position. So you don't have to move this value. So you just simply sort the green one and sort the pink one. So you have to perform quick sort A from L to S minus 1 and quick sort A S plus 1 to R. That's all. Okay, because P is at the correct position. Okay, this is a quick sort. Okay, this one is trying to show you, okay, the same thing, right? I've already show you. I'm not sure whether you have this figure. Okay, I'm not sure, but I will. Okay. And then after you finish this one, right? You have the first pass, right? This is to subdivide the whole array into two parts. This is the first part, and this one is the second part, where we have 5 as a pivot, and supposed to be at the middle of the list. And then you have to perform the quick sort for these 4 arrays, array of 4 elements here and array of 3 elements here. And then you have to continue with the next one, right? So now S is equal to 4. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? S is equal to 4. So you have to sort from 0 to 3, 0 to 1, 2, 3, and 5, 4, plus 1 is 5, 5, 6, 7, okay? So it's very easy, right? Quick sort will start from array L from 0 to 7. 7 is the number of, 7 plus 1 is 8, is the number of elements in this array, A, right? And we have to start from the index L is equal to 0 and R is equal to 7, right? Once we select the pivot at the 0, index 0, that is 5, right? And then we can come up with 5, go to the correct position. It's right position, correct position, that is S is equal to 4. So you have to subdivide into 0 to 3, and 5 to 7, and then you continue with the performing quick sort L from 0 and R to 3, and then quick sort of A, L is R and R, L is 5 and R is 7. So, and then you can continue with this one, right? L is 0, R is 3, and then, okay. You can keep going, performing the quick sort, a whole R partitioning, and then you can come up with 2, right? 2 is a pivot, and then you have two arrays, right? 1 and 3, 4. And then now you have L is 2, R is 3, and then performing quick sort, and then S is equal to 2, and then stop. Okay, if you try to write the program, try to show the step by step of the algorithm like this, so you can know how many comparisons for each step, okay, of subdivision. Okay, you need to compare many times. Okay, now we have to. After partitioning with 5, you have this one and this one, and then 5, and then you have 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 7, 8, 9. Okay. So, in conclusion, right, quick sort, the best case for the quick sort is n log n base 2. There is no problem with that, right? Because you have known that quick sort is the best one for the sorting algorithm, and the best case of the quick sort will have the complexity big O n log n base 2, right? If you can split the, okay, approximately at the middle of the subarray, you can get the best case. But if the input is strictly increasing array or decreasing array, right? So you will have the worst case scenario, that is big O is n squared. So this is the worst case, right? When you pick up the pivot, right? And then you can get this one, and this one is the smallest element. So you cannot, how can I say, you cannot optimize the remaining list. Okay, so you still have the n less to the power 2 or n squared scenario. But in average, right, big O is n log n base 2, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. But statistically, the actual Cn is equal to 1.39 n log n base 2. This is the approximate number of the comparison or the operations in the quick sort algorithm. Okay. Do you have any question? So I have already given you about the quick sort in C programming as well, right? You can find out in the textbooks. And then, okay, what time is it? It is, okay, actually we still have the in class, right? So maybe I leave this for you to finish, right? You can do the same question for the merge sort and quick sort, okay? But now for the quick sort, you have to show the array transformation and draw the tree of recursive calls made. Okay, find a quick sort by using the group, right? Okay, this slide is about a comparison between two efficient sorting algorithms, that is merge sort and quick sort. For merge sort, right, it needs to merge after splitting. Okay, the merging function will be employed. While segment sorted independently after splitting, quick sort. For merge sort, the same average and worst case complexity in log n. But for quick sort, right, best case and average case is n log n, but worst case is n square. For merge sort, you need to use the extra space big O n while merging. While merging, you need to use the extra space, but for the quick sort, you don't have to use any extra space. And for the merge sort, more read and write operation due to merging, but for quick sort, less read and write operation. This is a comparison table for the merge sort and quick sort algorithms. Okay, here we are to the question and answer. Do you have any question? Don't forget to type one to the chat box so I can have the class attendance for today. Okay, if you don't have the question, you can leave the room. Thank you for your attention. Please try to finish also the in-class exercise and also work homework, okay, in group. You don't have to submit to LEB2, right? The next lecture, I will ask you to show the result. Thank you very much. See you next week. What does it mean by using extra space? Suhani, it means that you have to declare extra array for merging. You need to define or declare an extra array for merging. Okay. Thank you for your question.